Well, it's a super shiny, unbelievably cold frickin' day. And the guitar fairy came by and dropped off some stuff. Look at this. It's a grocery bag filled with guitar based stuff. So, this could be fun. I guess we'll call this one Guitar Evaluation, because I don't know what's in here. And they all need help. So let's begin. Gibson ES-335 Dot Cherry. Sweet. Let's take it out of the box. So the guy that brought it over told me it has tuning issues. And I'm pretty sure I can tell why, because it's got these teeny weeny tiny little strings on it, and that's really not what the guitar requires. So I'm guessing the intonation's all out of whack because somebody put real skinny strings on it. But I'll do a little measuring and see what gauge of stuff's on here. The neck is very nice and straight, and other than that, there's no reason this shouldn't play right. But he got it from the shop like this, and they handed it to him and said, "Oh, it's fine. Here, have it back." But I can tell just by looking at it, the strings are too skinny, and they're probably not sitting properly in the nut. So we'll have a look-see and figure that out. Okay, let's look at the next one. It's a Gretsch. It's a White Falcon. Don't store your guitar with the strap on it in the case like that. You're asking for trouble. I hate to say it, but it's true. Well, let's get it out of the box. Isn't this something else? Wow. So this one, the guy just got it and just wants me to go over it and just have a look. And the neck is sort of really wiggly on this. Like, I can see, well, we'll just see if the truss rod works and sort of pull that out. There's quite a bit of a jump here. No roller bridge though, so that's sort of interesting. And once again, I'd say the string gauge on this guy's really, really slim, because these just don't like. Bixby's don't like skinny gauge strings. This has been learned, the lesson been learned by experience in that area. Okay, last but not least, let's just see. This is brand new, the frets are brand new. And that Gibson, I think, is really new too. Let's see what else we got. Hold on. And last, and I'm pretty sure it is the least, what is it? Oh, Gooch, Yamaha, stand by. Okay, this one's definitely been well played. He lost one of his knobbies. Now he's ended up with a black guy. The frets don't look too bad. They could use some work. The fretboard's really, really dry. And when we look at the neck, it's pretty frickin' warped. There's a little bit too much bow, too much relief. The pickups are adjusted like shit. They're way too low. But it's weird because they don't seem to come up above the pickup rings. And I don't know, I guess we'll clean it up, set it up. I don't know, the frets need a little bit of work. So there you go, there's three things for Dave to do videos about in the near future. Oh no, there's another one, there's that bag of bolts over there, hold on. Well, this is going to be a Fender P-Bass project. The only twist is she's a left-hander. Again, hold on. So we're going to put some better real pickups in that. We got this Mighty Might licensed by Fender neck. We got a good deal on this, but I can tell why. The fret ends are not dressed very well. They're a little sharp, so I'll have to fix that. And a cool set of, this is the hardest thing to find, are the left-handed tuners. So this will be a knockaround bass. Oh, wait, hold on. We have, behind door number 22, the logo, but she's a lefty, so I gotta figure out how that worked out, how they did that. I think they cut it and reversed it, and so it had, but it'll read backwards, right? You see, and it'll say Fender there. I got some pictures, I'll figure it out. But people are asking me about these decaldeluxe.com, decaldeluxe.com. These are high quality reproduction restoration logos, so that'll be fun. I'll do another video of that. And yeah, so I got some stuff to do. Stay tuned, we'll get her all done. Cheers.